Hello again, YouTubers and Pokemon fans. I, of course, am Jeff, owner of the PokeCapital.com and ToysMCN.com, a YouTube network. For today's bonus video, here in the early morning, 8 a.m. Eastern, we have a PTCGO match for you guys. Using the packs we opened up yesterday against Everything Amiibo, we have each built a deck using only cards from those 14 packs, plus basic energies, and we'll now battle each other using those decks. If you want to see my deck before the battle, there should be an annotation on your screen right now to go to my unlisted video, which is a 8.5 minute like deck overview profile, whatever you want to call it, of my deck. I just figured it better to keep it separate since it got kind of long, just so you guys can get to the battle faster. So, video will cut here and we'll restart as soon as the battle has officially started. All right, and here we go against PVT Autobot. So he's got water, fighting, and colorless, which is good. Because we are heavily, heavily weak to fire. Although we do have some water in the deck, but him not having fire is definitely good. Yes, we will go first. Now, if you didn't see deck profile video, I will just tell you we are very, very low on energies, and this is not a good opening hand. Or not energies, on trainers. We only have 6 trainers, 2 of which are dive ball. We got the 1 rare candy. We only have 2 supporters, teammates, and 1 Professor Birch's observations. So, it will be interesting. And the rare candy is in there to get Ludicolo out, if we can find the Lotad. I have 1 of each Ludicolo in here. 1 of the grass, 1 of the water with ancient trait. The grass one's the one I want because the ability is basically Pokemon Catcher. Flip a coin, if heads, switch your opponent's Pokemon. And of course, these are the 3 types we play. Grass, water, and metal. And of course, the one kind we don't have in our hand is the kind we need for the only best Pokemon we have. Well, there's Phoebus in his deck. There we go. And he's got Groudon EX, which I wrecked with in my pre-release. Luckily for us, it's weak to grass, which is the type we have most heavily in the deck. But we'll see what happens with that. So he attaches a water energy to the Groudon. So that's good for us, because his active has 2 retreat. And unless he plays Escape Rope, he has to either get knocked out or whatever, so we have some time to buy here. So that's good. Let's see. Quick attack does 10. Can do 20 with a coin flip. I might as well do some attacks, I just might as well. So it's, even if we get heads every time, it will take, let's see, we'll take at least 2 attacks to knock it out. It's possible next turn we'll choose not to attack. Yeah, we got heads. So next turn I may not attack, just because if I let Groudon come out and start doing Ripclaw, I'm going to have nothing on the board, and this game is going to be over mighty, mighty quick. And we don't want that. We want, a real match. If I could get Linoone out, that'd be great, because he can do 30 to a bench. 30 damage to one of your opponent's bench Pokemon. So that would knock out Phoebus on the spot with just 30 HP. But he's still awesome, because it is Phoebus. But it is what it is. Let's see, what's he got up his sleeve here? And as the turn's going to take a little longer, because he is recording this as well. His end, his perspective of this battle, will be up on his channel, Everything Amiibo. So he's talking just like I am, only you can't hear both of us in the same video. So he just passes. Interesting. But we have nothing much to do either, which stinks. I don't even think I'm going to attach an energy here, honestly. But the fact he didn't attach, oh, man. Do I just push? Because Ripclaw would be a 2-hit knockout against us. I'm going to push. What the heck? Win in Rome. Which, he's from Europe. Not from Rome, I don't think. But we get the knockout. Maybe we'll find something good in the prizes. Just another water energy. So that's nothing too fantastic. But not much we can do about that, unfortunately. So he pushes out the Groudon. We'll see if he's got the energy. Oh, he wanted that Rhyhorn to happen to get knocked out. Oh, he bided me into that. Touche, touche. We have 1 teammate in our deck. Be nice if we could find it. That could seal the game here. Maybe I'll take a Fighting Energy and a Milotic, get the Phoebus evolved, and make it so Groudon can start doing some attacks. If he gets heads, we lose our grass energy, which should be not good. We need him to keep getting tails, and we need to keep getting heads with our quick attack. And we got two straight heads quick attack, so, the game is due to give a tails. Just so happens that he'll be the next one to flip a coin, most likely. Be interesting to see. Well, we don't know what he takes, but based on what he plays, if he plays a fight energy in my low tech, I'll assume that's what he got. There's the fight energy. Is he going to evolve my low tech? I'm going to assume that he plays my low tech, because otherwise I don't think he'd have Phoebus in there, unless he's just trolling because of our two Phoebus one pack thing. Oh, weakness policy to boot. So that might be what he took then. Come on, tails. Tails, 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 tails. Oh, gosh, no. No. Well, isn't this lovely? Well, since we have him, I'm going to attach a water to the benched one anyway. And we pass. Not a good hand at all. Two Treecko's, we just have the one Grovyle, one Sceptile. Not a good start at all. Like to have some sort of matched, paired up thing with, basics and evolutions, but we did not fare so well. He's got Scans bench now. He's got an energy on the Phoebus. I've not seen my Lotic yet, though. Maybe his plan is to, like, have his final attack with Phoebus. Just say that he beat me with the best card ever. What's this Phoebus do again? I know it's better than the Flash Fire one. He gets tails, but that doesn't matter. Send him out. Hey, we got a Kyogre! And of course, now we only have the two water energies, but, well, it's better than nothing. Unfortunately, he's a one-hit knockout to Groudon if he gets the energy on there to start massive rending. But, yeah. Let's see. Spring Tides, 30 times the number of heads. So it could do zero, it could do infinity. But, yeah. Anything you do beyond 30 is great. But you never know. You could get lucky. I could knock out the Groudon in one hit with that attack. You never know. Crazier things have happened. We have gotten, I think, four straight heads in this game already. Oh, there's our first tails of the game. So that energy gets to. Oh, he got tails. Never mind. That was the first tails. Okay. We're good. We're good. So energy there. And end our turn. Obviously, we're limited on what kind of good decks we can build when you only open 14 packs of one set, especially when it comes to trainers. And trainers are what really make a deck work these days, namely supporters like Juniper and Skyla helps, all that stuff. But we have just the two supporters in the deck, so that limits us greatly. He evolves the Skitty. Delcatty can move energy attached to your Pokemon any way you like. That's handy. And play rough. Can potentially do 60 for two. And we're not in a very good spot here. I'd like to have at least two, ideally three bench right now, and now we're gonna have zero. And now he's got all his tail flips out of the way, so we'll probably, get rid of our energy. Oh, there we go, there we go. Lotad! We can't use the rare candy yet though, because that counts as evolving your Pokemon, unfortunately. But next turn we can put out the Ludicolo. And we may take some, benched guys out here. At least slow him down. So we'll attach here. And let's hopefully do at least some damage here with Spring Tides. One. Just one. So 30 damage. So he's down to just 150. So let's see. Does 80 plus 10 to each of his bench only? So if he gets tails here, I probably have to attach. And, ooh, I'd probably attach to Kyogre and just go with the big attack. He's gonna go for the massive rend though here next turn, most likely. Although he missed energy drop last turn, so I'm going to assume that he top decked that energy since he didn't play one last turn. So it's possible they won't have any energy to play next turn. Fingers crossed. Because it's gonna take two Ocean Cyclones to knock him out. And that's if he misses on the coin flips here. So I need him to get two tails, basically. Oh, that's brutal. And I'm sure he's going to take a water energy away. Yep. So that hurts. So now I think what we have to do is bide some time. So I'm going to rare candy into the Ludicolo, because that's a thing. Come on. Oh, because I had to hit okay, apparently. 80 and heals 20 from each of your Pokemon. So that's not terrible. We only have the one energy, so I'm gonna save that for now. First, let's see. Let's try this. We'll sell the Delcatty if we can. Of course that fails anyway. So we attach to the Kyogre. We need him to not get an energy and get a Tails, and we need a top deck of water, and just hope good things happen. So it's more like, well, Ludicolo's one hit knockout too, so there's no good answer right now. I'm gonna attach to Ludicolo, and who knows, maybe we'll get like 10 heads and knock it out. Or none. None's good too. Not good. Not good at all. But not much we can do. I wouldn't say we've like misplayed at all. The only arguable misplay is knocking out the Rhyhorn, because that allowed him to play teammates and get the energy and possibly the weakness policy, which obviously is helpful. I'm not sure offhand what my Lodick does, but if he gets my Lodick, he's good to go, because if he gets knocked out, he gets more energy, and he gets the heads. Oh my god. Bye-bye, water. We top-decked the water. Wow. So if he had gotten Tails there, I would have been upset, because then we could have used Ocean Cyclone. But at least we get to try some coin flips again, I guess. It's our best option. Suppose we got a, if attached there, we have to top deck a water. Let's see here. Tails. If I got heads of an intro, which I'd send out, probably a Delcatty just to stall, although it does only have one retreat. So I probably want to try and knock the Phoebus. It's getting ready to be better. But let's see what happens. All the Tails. All the Tails. Oh, man, oh, man, oh, man. Can we get one flip? One flip in our benefit would be nice. Because we need some luck the way our hands, our drawing's gone here. I love to draw into PBO. Or if we can draw before Kyogre gets knocked out, teammates. Just so we can, you know, mount something here. Fresh water set. Yeah, like you need that. Rub it in. There's my Lodic. So when you place Pokemon from your hand to evolve, you put a card from your discard pile into your hand. So that's probably why I played fresh water set, just to get that back, potentially. Akasrul can do 60. And you may have your opponent switch Pokemon. Fun stuff. And he gets teammates back. Oh, even better. I forgot that was there. Even though I just talked about teammates. Oh, this is not going well. I don't know why these like won't go away from me, but oh well. 30 and hey, you got Tails too. It's a miracle. And we get a Volbeat, which requires a grass energy to do the main attack. I call it the main attack because it's more likely to do. And we have very limited special condition happening. I don't know how to phrase it, but Pester is not going to do 60, bottom line, basically. All right, so now if we get heads, we're sending out Delcatty and trying to stall a little bit. Or not. And this is one of the main things I wanted to get out in this game. And I got it out, and it's 0-3 on the flips. Maybe Spring Tides will get, let's see, he's got 170 left. So we need 6 straight heads for the knockout. And if we knock him out, he gets to use teammates, but yeah. Oh my god! I think that's 5 straight Tails for me. 5 straight Tails for me. Oh man. Brutal. At least he's gotten 1 or 2 straight Tails on his flip. So at least we can try to attack. But my gosh. Yeah, we have Dewblade in hand, by the way, Which, if we could get that out and have two energy on it, we could put Groudon down to just 10 HP, which would be very handy. But, yeah. Goodbye, Kyogre. Oh, man. So, we'll send out Volbeat. We'll hope to get Delcatty active just to stall, maybe, for a turn. Because that's all we can do. Oh! Oh! Well, this is why whenever I have played the game competitively, I always shied away from anything that involved coin flips best I could. Because this is what can happen. You can get tails on every single flip, and you're just screwed. If you can, like, get 60 plus percent heads, and you have a lot of flippy stuff in your deck, you stand a great chance. But if you get, close to 0%, your chances are very, very bad. That's all there is to that. And like Pokemon Catcher being a flip now, I'll just play Lysander. I'm not going to touch Pokemon Catcher because I know I'll go like over three, over four if I play all the catchers in a game and just lose. So, well, we got another basic Pokemon and we have his evolution. So that means that he'll at least have to take six prizes this game, believe it or not. Can we get a heads? Yay! We got one heads! Hip, hip, hurrah. I'm sure I'll have the energy retreat and send Groudon right back out and smash our face in. But at least we can say we got one heads from Ludicolo. One for four. He's got a big enough hand. I don't know what he's all got in that hand. He's got to have some energy. Another experience share. That's a lot of cards to be holding. I wish I had that many cards right now. I wish I had seven energy in play. And how does he have all these trainers? I don't think we drew any experience shares. I know we didn't get any fresh water sets. There's his energy, so he can retreat. Or he can use replace if he wants to. Up to him. Maybe he will just to try to make the game last, but. Oh, so ugly. And there's Groudon, and goodbye, Ludicolo. Coolo! I wish Helio had a one energy attack. So that's just checkmate. There's nothing we can do now. Because he's got two retreat, most evolve, attach, and GG. GG. I guess. Oh, man. And the Pokemon that I smash everyone's face in. You would! You would! So he'll finish the game with no damage on his side of the board. But I did take one prize, so you can't say it's a shutout at least, where I did no damage the whole game. I did get one knockout, which sadly may have been the biggest mistake of the game, though. So, oh well. Like I said, I probably should have not attacked and gave myself some time, but even so, I never was in a great position. At best, I would have had Kyogre to do 130, like, or to do 80. And then he like would have attacked, discarded my water energies, and wouldn't be able to sustain that anyway. So I didn't really see a chance from the start there, it would seem. But at least in our polls, we did get five ultra rares from the 14 packs: Gardevoir EX, Mega Gardevoir EX, Aggron EX, which is in the deck, Trevenant EX, which is in the deck, and what was the last one? I'm blanking, but I think we had five ultra rares. Oh, a Primal Kyogre EX full art. Maybe it wasn't full art, but we couldn't play that one. So that'll do it for this battle, our bonus video of the day. Come back at 6 p.m. Eastern on this channel, and we will have a Primal Clash booster box battle for you guys against our Toys MCN partner. So thank you all for watching, and I hope to see you all then.